Hello, I'm Reverend Nick Phillips, Chair of the Board of Crucifusion, a network of support for Christ-centered clergy in the United Church of Canada. I also welcome you into this holy season of Advent, the season of waiting, the season of anticipation. I'm sitting in my church and we haven't really brought out our Christmas decorations yet. That's still to come in a few days. But I've pulled out our Advent wreath to remind us of that. This is often a sign in many of our churches of what is to come. Over the next couple of days, my church will be a busy church, a celebrating church, as we come together for a couple of meals and bring the church together to decorate our sanctuary, to make it as beautiful as we can for our Sunday services. It's such a joyous time of year at times, this season of Advent, as we celebrate with our friends, our neighbors, our churches, our families, the gifts of life that we share. But this is also a bit of a dark season. The nights are so long, the days feel so short. As the sun sets earlier and earlier every day through much of Advent. And so we look for light. We search for hope. We search for meaning. And so that's when we need to turn to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Throughout the season of Advent, we'll talk a lot about him. We'll talk about his birth. We will celebrate his birth on Christmas, and we will wait. But we're not waiting for his birth because he's already been born over 2,000 years ago. What we're anticipating is his promise to return. The gift of life he continues to share, because we're reminded that his birth, his life, and his death do not end the story. The story still continues today through his resurrection and through his promise that he will return. So let's remember throughout the Advent season that Jesus has come and he's still to come again. That's where we can find hope. For if our Savior had lived and died, where would be our hope? Our hope is in that he still lives today, and he still walks with us. What is it at the end of the Gospel of Matthew? Jesus says, "I am with you always, to the end of the age." What a great hope we have in that message. What great power there are in those words, knowing that we are never alone. Jesus Christ has come, yes. He has come for all of us. The Gospel of John reminds us that Jesus has come so that we may have life and have it to the fullest. And so we celebrate that Jesus has come, that we have life, and that we have hope. Hope that in this darkened world, this dark time of year, that the light still shines. The light of Jesus still shines in our churches, in our homes, and in our lives. Jesus has come and as a result of his life, his death, and his resurrection, and the gift of his Holy Spirit, the church has been born. Our churches are based on the stories of Jesus, the life of Jesus, and the hope he extends to us still today. Now, my church is in a small town of Cape Breton, just a couple thousand people. Your church may be in a big city. Your church may be out in the country in the middle of nowhere. And sometimes even in all of those places, we can feel alone. We can feel isolated when we speak of Jesus and no one shares our joy, no one shares our hope. But together, the churches can share the hope of Jesus with each other and with our communities. because we know Jesus is still with us today. Our churches aren't perfect, but God is, and He sent us His perfect Son. The gift in the manger of irregular circumstances at a strange time. But His life is an example for all. And He does bring us hope. And so on this weekend, our churches will light our first Advent candle. We'll light our candle. We light our candle of hope and reminder that the light still shines. Jesus Christ, light of the world, walks with us even today. Let us pray. Holy God, we thank You for life. We thank You for light. We thank You for hope. We thank You that Jesus Christ has come and that we may have life to the fullest. God, watch over our churches. Watch over the United Church of Canada as we seek to be faithful followers of Your way, Your Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, in whose name we pray in this holy season as we wait for His return. Amen.